everyone, welcome back to Tuesday Tips, a weekly series where I will offer tips, suggestions, or advice on how to maintain or improve mental and physical health and well-being. Today's tip is kind of a double two-sided of the same coin, perhaps. Maybe you are the type of person who has a thousand things going on every day. You're scheduled like just like one thing after the other. Perhaps your job is super demanding and you're just like working all the time with like barely any time to like eat or sleep or shower. Maybe you are responsible for a bunch of kids. Maybe you have children. And maybe you also have a job, and maybe you also have this. You just have a lot of different responsibilities and really like little time to like rest or take care of yourself. Maybe you feel very empowered and very strong and very like, look at all I can do and get done during the day. Hold. Perhaps you're a different type of person who doesn't have much going on. Maybe you spend a lot of your day just kind of sitting around, laying around. In your free time, maybe you are watching TV, scrolling on your phone, just kind of sitting around feeling like you're not doing much and feeling like you would like to be doing something. I'm going to speak to both of those today. So on the one hand, super, super scheduled, barely any time for yourself. I want you to allow yourself to rest. Allow yourself to take a break. If the type of job you have does not allow for that, perhaps this is a bigger thing and you need a better work-life balance. That's to be discussed in further detail. If you want to discuss it with me, reach out because I can help you with that. That kind of aside, if you just feel like you're overscheduled and you don't have time for yourself, or if you feel guilty taking time for yourself, I want you to know that it is so important and so helpful to let your body rest, to let your body recharge. Sit down, watch TV for 30 minutes or a half hour, let your brain shut off. Let yourself have no responsibilities for anybody else or anything else. Allow yourself to rest. If you're training for something, if you're training for a race or if you're training for an event, if you're working towards something and things are not feeling good, if you feel like you have an injury, if you just are feeling tired and overworked, I want to tell you that it is okay to take a day off. If you are working constantly nonstop and you really need a break, is it okay for you to take a day off work? Is it okay for you to take a Saturday or a Sunday or whatever, a day that you are not working? Maybe you have other responsibilities. Can you shift those responsibilities to another day? Can you take a day for yourself? Can you take half a day? Can you take an hour for yourself to do something that is for you, that allows you to rest and recharge, and not being lazy, to not think of it as that you are being lazy or that you are being irresponsible. You are super responsible. You are super active. You have a lot of responsibilities. Give yourself permission to like have no responsibilities, to just like sit on the couch, to just like let your brain shut off for a minute, an hour, more than a minute. Just give yourself that time to rest, because a lot of times what will happen if we don't have any time to ourselves during the day, when we get in bed at night, we are going to delay going to bed because, oh, that's our time. So I'm just going to read, or I'm going to scroll on my phone, and I'm just going to like stay awake even though I know I should be going to bed, because that's the only time that our brain is like, well, this is my time, so I'm gonna stay awake. I need this time for myself, but you also need sleep. So could probably spend a lot longer talking about that, but give yourself permission to rest, to relax, to recharge. You will feel better. And last thing, don't be hard on yourself if it doesn't happen right away. If you set out to give yourself an hour and you can't, you make it 10 minutes, cool. You give yourself 10 minutes just yourself to rest. That's fantastic. Do it again tomorrow or next week. Give yourself another 10 minutes, but try for 12 and just build and see how it feels. And I promise, if you are able to work it into your day, however, whatever frequency, that it will start to just become routine. On the other side of the coin, if you feel like you are not being active, if you feel like you're kind of just like wasting the evening away, wasting the weekend away, that you're just kind of sitting around, you're sitting on the couch, you're being inactive, not really doing much, I want to encourage you to be active. So take a walk around the block. Take a walk to the corner and back. If you are one who orders groceries, or if you order takeout a lot, keep ordering it. That's not my job to tell you what to do, but go pick it up instead of getting it delivered. You'll save money too. Go, if you need a reason to go outside, go look at the, this sounds so lame, go look at the sunset. I don't know if that's a good enough reason for you. I love looking at the sunset and the sunrise. Sunset is potentially easier in your day. But to going back on a previous week, put it in your calendar, set an alarm on your phone, go outside. Even if you just go, if you live in a house or an apartment building, even if you walk out your front door and you stand on the sidewalk, you did that. You got off your couch, you got out of your house or your apartment, you got outside, and that's it. Like, start there. It doesn't have to be like, oh, I have to be outside for 2 hours. Be outside for 2 minutes, and then you can go back in, and then the next time you do that, be outside for 5 minutes. Build it. Make plans with a friend to meet up. Maybe there's someone who you are like texting with all the time. They live close to you. Hey, let's actually talk in person. What's that like? Or maybe they don't. Maybe they're on the other side of the country, but maybe let's do a video call and let's be outside. Let's find like a Wi-Fi spot outside. Or like, I'm gonna go for a walk. I'll text you when I get back. Or like, let's go. I'm gonna go watch the sunset. I'm gonna send you pictures. When the sun sets for you on the other side of the country in 3 hours, send me pictures. Little things to kind of hold each other accountable also. Like the larger picture with both of these things is to just like small steps help. And these little small steps will eventually, you will eventually see big changes. So if you are someone who is just overscheduled to the max and you are feeling just burnt out and exhausted, like you have no time for yourself, give yourself permission to take time for yourself because it can be really bad if you don't. Like you're gonna burn out, you're gonna stress out, you might get sick. There is a relationship between us feeling stressed and being so busy and getting sick because our body manifests things that are going on and it's all connected and it's all working together. Give yourself permission to take a break. Give yourself permission to take the day off, to take a couple hours for yourself, to take 10 minutes for yourself. That is not in bed when you should be sleeping. Try to separate that. On the reverse, if you feel like you are not doing anything, go outside and take a walk. Go just stand outside and take some breaths outside. Go look at a garden, or if you have a garden, start gardening. We're in the winter months here, as I'm filming this, so perhaps not the best seasonally appropriate suggestion. But if you like the snow and it snows, go outside when it's snowing. Like I love doing that. Take pictures. Go outside and take pictures. You know, text a friend and tell them to join you, or tell them, I'm gonna go outside, I'm gonna send you pictures, or I'm gonna let you know what I see. That way, you have a little bit of accountability to help get moving too. Perhaps you want to start running, or you want to start some sort of activity. If you want to find like a club, or I don't know what they're called, but different like a sports team that is formed from just people who want to play just for fun. I can't think of the name right now, but like find one of those, like an after work, like soccer team or tennis or basketball or something like that. Sign up for a race, sign up for a 5K if you want to start running. Give yourself a goal to work towards if you know that will work for you. So I hope that you found this helpful. I hope that you are able to, on the one hand, take time for yourself, give yourself permission to rest, and on the other hand, help hold yourself accountable, maybe hold a friend accountable, to like start to incorporate more activity into your day-to-day. I will see you next week with another tip. Have a good week.